Hello everyone, so today is not a facecam video because I'm just bored. So in today's video, I will show you how to create and prepare assets for your webtoon in Clip Studio Paint. And before everything else, nope, I do not know how to make it in Procreate or other softwares, so please don't ask, okay? I really don't know. Anyway, on today's menu, we have part 1, make materials, so name cards or many layers objects you want to edit. The part 2 will be textures, how to create a repetitive pattern to use it as a texture. The part 3 will be about making a crowd brush, which can be really useful to save a lot of time. The part 4 will be about making jewels, making necklaces or earrings, etc. And the part 5 will be about making laces or color changing brushes. And by the way, all the jewelry brushes I made in this video and the crowd brush I made are available on my online shop and on Acon3D. The links will be in the description, so don't hesitate to take a look. Here I first start by drawing what I want to use, so I needed a name card that I will use to introduce every new character in my webtoon. The useful thing here is that you will keep the same base every time and you will just have to edit what's inside. As you can see here, and also what I do recommend to do, is to always use a line work layer to make your outlines, just to prevent pixelization of your artwork if you resize it in the future. Now that your base is done and well organized, just put it into a folder. Also important detail, the space between your artwork and the edges of your canvas is taken in consideration when you save it. Just beware about that. Here is the difference with and without space. Also remember to delete the background layer. It will be taken in consideration when you will save it as a material too, so don't forget that. Now let's save it to be able to use it whenever we need it. Just go on your folder, then save the material and model. Select a folder where to find your artwork easily, then just click on OK. It now saves your whole canvas as a material and you can edit it however you want. Let me show you how to use it. Drag your artwork from this arrow right here and drop it on your canvas. As you can see, it kept all the layers of the original artwork. That's it, you just have to edit it. You can do this for any types of artwork with multiple layers that you want to use as base. This is why I use it for my character's introduction. Now let's create a texture. So textures are super cute, fun and easy and quick to do. So to create a texture, you obviously have to create a pattern. I just recommend to center your pattern well. So as you can see here, I needed a tiny, cute and fun broom texture. And so to center your texture well, you can totally make it symmetrical. But here, as you can see, it wasn't really symmetrical. It was just repeating itself. So what I recommend to do is to cut your pattern and place each part at the opposite edges of your canvas. So for example, here I have a square, so I place the left part of the square at the right edge of my canvas and the right part of the square at the left edge of my canvas. And here again I cut my square in two and I place the top part of it at the bottom edge of my canvas and I place the bottom part of my square at the top of my canvas. So this is how you make it repetitive. In Clip Studio, you have a menu to align objects, if I can say it like this. So just use it, it's super useful. As you can see here, you just have to click on one button and it will help you to align your pattern. Also, it depends on your pattern, but don't forget to delete the background layer if you want a transparent texture. You can also play with low opacity, it will be taken in consideration. As you can see, just don't hesitate to test your texture, you know, just to be sure you're completely fine with it. When you're done with it, like the crowd brush we'll see later, save the material. But this time, not as a material like we did for the name cards, but as an image. Now you will have a picture type of file, not a multiple layers one. The huge difference between these two is that the multiple layers material will keep all your canvas's layers, but when you save it as a picture, it will only save what you're selecting or the layer you are on. As the previous part, select a name and a folder, but also also important thing to do here, click on use it as a paper texture. This is really important for your texture to be content as a texture. Not like the name cards, when you need a texture, just drag it from this area right here to your canvas and you will be able to resize the pattern while creating a texture layer. Ta-da! You have a cute and beautiful texture layer. I just love doing this, to be honest. If I could just do this my whole life, I would do it. Here, as you can see, I wanted to create a raccoon willow texture because my character Willow is stealing like everything she sees. So I really like this texture, like she's so cute in it. And to use it, this is really simple. Again, you just drag and drop and you can also put background color behind, etc. As you will be able to see, you can have a lot of fun doing this. Now let's go to the next part. Okay, so first for this part, you have to know that you can totally manage to buy crowd brushes on the Clip Studio assets or on Acorn 3D. This is what I did, but I still needed a witch's crowd brush and I didn't find this type of brush on Acorn, so I made it. This is also how I got the idea of this video, by the way. Sometimes you need NPCs that fit more your webtoon aesthetic, especially if you don't have a modern fantasy or an Arabic aesthetic webtoon. And even if making the crowd brush can be a bit long at first, trust me, you will save a lot of time during the process after that. Now let's make it a brush. So first you start by creating a new file. Obviously this is the file where you will draw all of your crowd. I recommend starting with sketching all of your NPCs to make the line after, then the flats and the colors. And again, remember to make your line work always on a vector layer and not a simple layer to prevent pixels. From my crowd brush, I also decided to make a baby witch's brush and an adult witch's brush because in the first episode of my webtoon there will be a lot of kids, so it was natural to me to do it. Also for adult brushes, since the angles are more difficult and I did not want to lose my time thinking about anatomy, I used the 3D bodies from CSP to help. As you can see, I made a front and a perspective versions of my characters just in case for some panels, you know, sometimes you have a pretty difficult angles, so I just wanted to do that. Now this is really as simple as that, just sketch, then line and color. Now tiny tips, if you want to draw more NPCs without drawing them over and over, you can change the color of one batch to create a new one. Trust me, it will give the illusion that you have more NPCs than you actually have. Now as you can see, my brush wasn't 100% clean because NPCs are usually in the background, etc. It's not like you have to be perfectly perfect, it just has to be clean a little bit. Also for the shadows, I made really simple shadows, you know, just for them to be really done, but not something really strong. So now that we have done every characters, let's turn them into brush. And this is almost the same process as the texture. This time, as you can see, I have the two characters besides each other, so I'm selecting one character at a time and click on edit, save the material, image. But this time, the difference with the texture, you don't have to click on make it a paper texture, but make it a brush tip. Again, put a name and choose a folder and click on OK. Also choose a name that will help you to find your brushes again, because after that we will have to find it to add them to the brush. And also, if you are like me and you are getting bored of saving all of your characters, you can totally make an automatic actions to save it automatically. If you want, one day I can make a video on it, but it's not the subject of the video. And when you have all of your pictures saved here, you are going to create your brush. Also, please don't forget to save your file here, you know, just to have a clip file that you can edit whenever you want. Even if sometimes I am using the crowd brush from this era, we will here create a real brush, like not just a material you can drag and drop, but really a brush that you can draw with it. So what I personally do to create a brush, I go on this three lines here and I click on create a tool from the default ones. Look at my screen, please. And then I create my brush and I choose the totally simple pencil, one of the normal pencil. Don't worry, we will edit it in a way that we will create a brush. So just choose a normal brush, like a pen brush, and click on OK, like on add here. So now that we have all our NPCs and our brush, let's mix both of them to create the perfect crowd brush. So you go here on on your tool settings and you go on pencil tip, and you will be able to choose your asset, so the NPCs you want to add in your brush. First, click on material here, and on this icon, just write the name you've put for your NPCs. This is also why it's important to put name that you can clearly find again for your NPCs, and choose as many NPCs you want into the same brush. As you will be able to see, all the NPCs you selected will be part of the brush. Now you have to go on trait or line and click on the tiny icon right here to make an eye appear, so you can choose the gap or the distance between each NPCs. And I really recommend to enable this option, so you can change the gap whenever you want and whenever you need without getting into the settings. So it will appear here into the tools option area, and ta-da! You have a crop brush. It's really, really simple to do. Also, as I show you here, I created multiple brushes for the crop and to duplicate a tool. It's really simple. So first you select the tool you want to duplicate, and then you can either click on the three lines here and duplicate the tool, or there is an easier way. You can just click here on the tiny plus button and it will duplicate it really quickly. And so you just have to reselect the assets you want into the tool as we did before. Go on settings, then brush tip, and to erase some of them you just have to click on it and click on the trash icon here. So if you want to delete some assets from a tool, you can totally do it. And so I have three NPCs a brush. It's easier to me to place them, and ta-da, here is your crowd brush. So that's it for this part. Again, my crowd brush is available on my online shop and on Incon3D, and now let's get into the next part. So for the jewels, there is a part that is the same as the crop brush, like for brooches or earrings for example, but we will also see how to make necklaces as ribbon brushes. As usual, start to draw your jewels. Here the only limit is your imagination, but you have to make your designs symmetrical, so place a CSP ruler in the middle of your canvas to help. So depends of your designs of course, the right and the left edges of your canvas have to be symmetrical to, you know, connect themselves for the ribbon to be really smooth and clean, or at least the edges have to be connected in a way that the pattern is really smooth. So like we previously saw in the texture part, if you want to do like me here, I made a moon pattern, you have to connect your two edges. So here I made a lot of different types of jewels with a lot of color combinations, and each of them is declined in gold, rose gold and silver. To be honest, it was a ton of work to do all of them, but remember that this is a pack I made here to sell it, so you can totally create one brush for the sake of your story, so it wouldn't be that long. I also used here for example the chains I made to put them into another design to create a new one. Also for each brush I made an earring and a necklace type of brush. Now that we have our different brushes prepared, let's save them. As for the crown, I select what I want to save, especially because the necklace and the earrings are on the same layer, so if you don't select it, the whole canvas will be taken as the material, but we don't want that. So again, I select my necklace first, save it, and then select the earrings to save it. As previously shown, when you select what you want, click on edit, save the material, image, choose a name, a folder, and do not forget to check the enable as a brush tip option. Until here, I save the earrings and the necklaces the same way. Now let's get into the creation of the brush. So for the earrings, this is the exact same process as for the crowd brush. First, create a new brush from the default ones, or of course you can duplicate the ones you have. Then go on the settings, brush tip, and click on material. Here you will select your earrings materials by clicking on this tiny icon. Again, when you save your materials, put a name you can find again. Now that this is added, go on trait or line, depends of what you have here, and enable the distance or the gap options here to see them in your tool area without getting into the settings again. This will allow you to change the gap between each earrings. Now that we are done with the earrings, let's create a necklace, aka a ribbon brush. It starts the same. Create your brush, go in the settings, materials, select your necklace image, and if you stop here, you will have this result. And this is obviously not what we are going for, so to fix it, this is quite simple. Return in your settings and select trait or line again, but instead of playing with the gap option, you have to enable the ribbon one here. As you can see on mine, it's not in the right direction yet, so you have to turn it. To do this, go on brush tip again and change the angle to 90 degrees. And voila! Here you have two choices. Whatever your preferences are, you can lay it like this, so the start and the end of your brush will follow your pen pressure, which can be great to create sorts of dynamism, or if you are like me and you prefer your jewels to have the same size from the start to the middle to the end of it, and change the size with the tool size here, you can go on your settings, go on pencil or tool size, and click on this tiny icon here. By disabling this option here, your jewel size will remain the same no matter what is your pen pressure. It will be adjustable only by clicking on a different size on the size panel here. And tada, we are done! You've just learned how to create jewels brushes for your drawings. Now let's get to the last part. So, laces and color changing brushes in general are quite similar to the other brushes, but there are a few differences in the process to make the color change happen. By color changing, I mean that when you will use your brush, it will be the color of your own primary and second color here. This will allow a lot of creativity, and of course you can also make it black and white. As always, start by creating your pattern on a vector layer. Again, be sure it is symmetrical or the edges are connecting smoothly. Again, for that, check the part 2 and the part 4. When your outline is done, make sure your line work is black and the inside, if you want to fill it of course, of your lace is white. Note that low opacity filling can work too. If you make it 50%, it will be a bit transparent. Okay, now here is the part that allows you to make it color changing, so pay attention. First, merge your filled and line work layer. Second, click on the three lines here and go to convert the layer. On the type here, you want to choose picture material or image material, depends of what you have, it's the last option. Then go on the expression color and choose gray, let it black and white and just click on OK. Now save it like you saved all of the other brushes, edit, save the material and image. Choose a name, a folder and as usual, enable the use as a brush tip option. Then you just have to create your brush, again from a default one or by duplicating one you already have. Now go on the settings, brush tip, material and choose your pattern. Don't forget to rotate it if needed, but also to go on trait to enable the ribbon option and ta-da! The magic happened, that's all you have to do. Again, as for the jewels brushes, you can decide to enable or not the pen pressure to have thinner starts and ends just by clicking on pen or tool size in the settings, then on this tiny icon and disabling or enabling these options here. And voila! Now when you change your primary or second colors, your laces will change their colors too. This one is one of my favorite options ever, to be honest. So this is enough for the brushes for today. Now let's wrap this up. Here we are, this is the end of the video. Hope everything helps you to prepare your webtoon in order to save time as much as possible. You may have to watch the entire video to put everything together, but at a certain point I did not want it to repeat everything too much, so hope it's enough. Let me know if you have any questions. As always, I'd be happy to answer it. See you in the next video. Bye bye!